A warm welcome to all. Now I am going to talk about William Shakespeare's Merchant of Venice, Act 4, Scene 1. This picture is court scene. In Act 4, Scene 1 of The Merchant of Venice, Shylock and Antonio appear before the Duke of Venice, and Shylock demands fulfillment of the letter of their contract. Antonio believes it is pointless to argue or try to reason with Shylock. The Duke hopes will Shylock relent and show Antonio some mercy. But Shylock makes it clear he has no such plan. He says he wants that pound of flesh because it is his humerus, and he refuses. When Bassanio offers him twice the sum of the original loan, Shylock compares his entitlement to Antonio's body to the way other Venetians feel entitled to do as they will with the bodies of their slaves and animals. The Duke calls in Dr. Bellario from Padua as well as a man named Balthasar, Dr. Bellario's colleague from Rome. This Balthasar is not Portia's servant, but actually Portia herself in disguise. She first appeals to Shylock to show Antonio mercy, because mercy is its own reward. She goes on to respond to Shylock's calls for justice by saying that in the course of justice, none of us should see salvation. We do pray for mercy. Shylock remains unmoved and stay unmoved. Even Bassanio offers to pay twice or 10 times the sum of the loan Portia, then bids Antonio to prepare for Shylock's knife. But when Shylock approaches Antonio with the knife, Portia stops him and says that the bond allows him a pound of Antonio's flesh, but it does not allow him any drop of Antonio's blood, since it's impossible for Shylock to take his pound of flesh without spilling blood. Shylock is found guilty of conspiring to commit murder against a citizen of Venice. The Duke spares his wife's life and instead takes half Shylock's fortune for the state and gives the other half to Antonio. Antonio asks the court to drop the fine of half his good to the state and says Shylock should keep the half of his fortune handed to Antonio as long as he leaves it to Lorenzo and Jessica. Antonio recurs to Shylock convert to Christianity. Shylock agrees to these terms and leaves the court. Antonio is freed and thanks this Balthasar fellow for the assistance. Portia, in disguise, asks for Bassanio's ring, the one she gave him when they were wed. When Bassanio refuses to part with the ring, she scolds him and takes her leave. Antonio then convinces Bassanio to send to this ring to legal scholar. Bassanio sends Graziano to catch up with the disguised Portia and give her ring. Antonio's trial represents a confrontation between ideas that define the religious act, the heart of Merchants of Venice. Act 4, Scene 2. In the Act 4, Scene 2 of The Merchant of Venice, outside the court, Portia instructs Nerissa to go to Shylock's home and have him sign the did that leave his property to Jessica and Lorenzo. But before she leaves, Graziano arrives to deliver Bassanio's ring and invite her dinner. She turns down the dinner invitation but accepts the ring and asks Graziano to show Nerissa the way to Shylock's house. Nerissa tells Portia she will try to get her own ring from Graziano. Portia believes she will get the ring easily and assures Nerissa they will indeed have the last word on their husbands. Thank you.